Welcome back to the adventure. Today we're adding drivers to our custom Windows XP installation disk. Windows XP was released in 2001 and was supported until 2014. So there's 13 years of hardware compatible with Windows XP. However, the drivers included with Windows XP are for hardware from the era when it was released. What we are doing here today is slipstreaming a wide range of drivers for various types of hardware into the installation disk, so we can reasonably install Windows XP on a system and have it fully functional without needing to hunt down a bunch of drivers. To get started, we need to extract the contents of the installation disk to a new folder on the desktop. In my case, it's new folder 3. For this task, I'm using Power ISO. This can take a few minutes to get everything copied over. Note that this is the same installation disk from the previous video. If you have a suggestion on other customizations you'd like to see, leave me a comment below. Once it finishes, we need to fetch the driver pack's base. This is the tool that will do the slipstreaming for us. What we get is a self-extracting executable that we can move to another new folder on the desktop. I will refer to it as new folder 4. Open new folder 4 and double-click on the driver pack's base. Some files and folders will appear. Once it's done extracting, we need to fetch some driver packs. From this list, we need to select what driver packs we want to use. All of the downloads are in a torrent format, so you'll need a BitTorrent client to download them. The key packs I recommend are LAN, Wireless LAN, Chipset, and Mass Storage. What we get are compressed files that contain the various drivers. There's no need to extract them. The compressed files can be copied to the driver pack subfolder under new folder 4. Some of these driver packs, like graphics and audio, are very large. We want to avoid exceeding the capacity of a CD, assuming we'll be using this on a CD anyway. Once the driver packs are copied over to the driver packs folder, we can double-click on the driver packs base. A window will pop up. Expand Settings on the left navigation bar, then click on Location. For our purposes, we want to select Disk for the installation platform and click the Browse button to locate new folder 3 on the desktop. If successful, the menu on the left will shift. Expand Settings again and click on Driver Packs. Select which driver packs you want to include. When finished, click the Slipstream button at the bottom. This process can take several minutes to complete. While this is processing, I want to take a moment to thank my patrons. With your support, I've been able to get some new tools that will allow me to make a variety of new videos. Thank you. Once finished, we can go back into Power ISO and open up the installation disk image. Copy the contents of new folder 3 into the disk image. Don't forget to save. For any viewers that want to support the channel outside of Patreon, please watch the video ads or share the video. The ads generate revenue, and the shares generate exposure. Both are extremely helpful to the channel. That's it. We now have a custom installation disk that includes a wide range of drivers for various hardware compatible with Windows XP. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.